And then it was over. With the archdemon dead, the darkspawn horde quickly crumbled. Most fled back into the deep roads. They would remain a threat in the years to come. But the blight had been ended before it had truly begun. Ferelden had been saved, and the entire kingdom rose up to joyously greet its new king. Grey Wardens stood beneath, and a new age began. But at what cost?
My friends, we are gathered to celebrate those responsible for our victory. Of those who stood against the Darkspawn siege of Denerim, there is one in particular who deserves commendation. The one who led the final charge against the Archdemon remains with us still, an inspiration to all he saved that day. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you the hero of Ferelden, the first Grey Warden to defeat the Blight since Gadahel 4 centuries ago. My friend, it is hard to imagine how you could have aided Ferelden more. I think it only appropriate that I return the favor. Is there any boon that you might request of Ferelden's king? If it is within my power, I will grant it.
The sacrifice of the Grey Wardens should not be forgotten again.
Now that's a very good point. I think we can begin with a monument here in Denerim, dedicated to the Grey Wardens who have fallen. Duncan, Riordan, all of them. And it is high time some scholars were collected to learn more about the Darkspawn. We'll face them again, with the dwarves as well as here. Let it also be known that the Arling of Amaranthine, once the land of Arl-Hau, is now granted to the Grey Wardens. There they can rebuild, following the example of those who went before them. What are your plans? Will you remain with the Grey Wardens?
The Darkspawn are still a threat. The Grey Wardens need me.
That they do. I'm glad one of us is staying with them at least. There's a group of Ferelden citizens waiting outside to get a look at their hero. I suggest you make at least a brief appearance before they storm the gate. Just tell the guard at the door when you're ready.
We did it, guys. We saved all of Ferelden. There's Eamon.
It is over. I can barely believe it. You stopped the civil war and then defeated the Blight. On behalf of Ferelden, allow me to say thank you. It truly cannot be said enough.
It was a close call. We were lucky.
As far as they're concerned, you saved the day without breaking a sweat. Let them have that. It's too bad that you aren't remaining here in the capital. The hero of Ferelden would have influence, but I understand. Myself, I will be remaining here to help Alistair. Tegan will take over the rule of Redcliffe, at least for the time being. Connor seems well enough, and Isolde refuses to speak of what happened. She says she never wants to go back. I cannot thank you enough. Joy of my existence. Tell me, have you noticed anything strange about the lad? He seems
No, I haven't noticed anything.
The way he looks at me at times, it's as if... No, that cannot be. It is my imagination. But here I am rambling on. I shall let you get back to your celebration, Warden. Enjoy it while you can.
Fergus?
When I heard that my little brother was not only a Grey Warden, but also leading Ferelden into battle, I was surprised, to put it mildly. Father, he would have been so proud of you. I know I am. You've done good. I never made it to the Battle at Ostagar. We were still scouting in the wilds when we were attacked by a party of Darkspawn. Most of my men were killed. I woke up 2 weeks later in a chastened hut, wounded and feverish. By the time I was able to sneak out of the wilds, you were already marching to Denerim. I tried to get word to High Ever. You can imagine what happened, I suppose.
I'm sorry for what happened to Oren and Oriana.
Yes, I'm trying not to think too much about them. Hal was a greedy, traitorous bastard. I just wish I'd been there to help you kill him. At least Amaranthe now belongs to the Grey Wardens. There's some justice in that, I think. I need to go back to High Ever. See if I can clean up the mess Hal made of it. I will see you soon, I hope.
Of course he will.
Good. High Ever won't be the same without everyone around. Take care of yourself, you hear? Or I'll find you and nag you like Mother did until you're ready to tear out your hair.
Liliana.
So here we are. The conquering hero has won the day, and now he takes his bow and exits the stage. A fine ending.
But... But this isn't a play.
Isn't it? We had danger, we had victory, and many characters. Truly, I could not have borne witness to a better play had it been on a stage. You know, I can't help now but think of my vision. The Maker sent me to help you, and look what you did. It's a miracle. It truly is. I've been asked by the Chantry to return to the Urn of Sacred Ashes. I need to make sure it's protected. Maybe pilgrims can even begin going there again.
Congratulations. It sounds like fun.
I expect to leave a month from now with a small army of Templars and priests. It will be a grand adventure of my very own. I'm looking forward to it. At any rate, you should get back to the celebration. We can speak another time.
No one right here to talk to. There's Zevran and Wayne.
I will be relieved when all this pomp and ceremony is done. Such events are perfect opportunities for assassins, after all. I can't help but expect the crows to appear at any moment, which would be a welcome break, mind you.
You don't have to stay, you know. You think the crows will still come after you?
Eventually. With Taliesin dead, it may take them time to figure out what has happened, but they are like the Tynes, predictable. You know, it does occur to me that staying in one place is only going to invite the crows to find me that much quicker. While fun, that might eventually get complicated. You said earlier that you were planning on returning to the Grey Warden fold soon. Is that true? The Grey Wardens seem to be a fun bunch to hang around, however. Maybe they won't mind a resident assassin. I'm an excellent mascot. And I promise not to get you into too much trouble. Well, no more than you get me into, anyhow. Well then, since we're going to be leaving together, we can speak after you have been sufficiently paraded in front of the populace. Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on you and make sure no one gets a clear shot. Not without paying me a great deal of coin, anyhow.
How you doing, Wayne?
The hero of Ferelden. My, my. How does it feel?
It's a little strange.
Of that I have no doubt. It's a title you'll be wearing for a long time to come, just as Loghain wore his. But it's not so bad, is it? A Blight defeated with the other nations barely becoming aware. Who could ask for better? I don't think many heroes ever do. I'm glad not to be on the receiving end of all this attention myself. I say, let the young have their fame. Not that I've gone without notice. Irving asked me to take over as first enchanter, but I don't wish to go back. Not after all this. Instead, I've decided to accept a position here at court. There's not been a mage advising the throne for a very long time.
Alistair asked you to stay?
He's a good lad, and his heart is in the right place. He wants to see the lot of mages improved, and I am willing to help him. I understand you will be leaving. I wish you good fortune on your journeys, wherever they may take you. If we do not see each other again, live well, Warden. And thank you.
Is there anyone I missed back here? Doesn't look like it. Anyone else I can talk to around here? There's Ogryn.
Humans have a better taste for spirits than I thought. The ale up here is actually good. Orzammar ale tastes like dirt in comparison. Probably because dirt in it. Go figure.
Enjoying yourself already, I see.
After what we went through, I think I've earned it. I think you've earned it. So I guess you're heading off soon, huh? Leaving the city?
That's the plan.
I'm thinking I'll stick around myself, at least for a bit. Well, that pot-bellied son of a whore Tegan said I'd pass out before drinking an entire barrel of pickle juice. Came to prove him wrong.
That's nice.
It's been good traveling with you, Warden. Don't get lost in the shuffle now.
I won't. Sten.
Call you hero. I have not heard it used before, but I think I understand the intent. The Arishak on occasion has declared a Kunari to be Kunoran Vel, one who serves as an example to others. Such examples are always made after their death, however, a death in service to the Kun. A living Kunoran Vel would be too proud. Of course you would say that. What the human custom has in common with our own is that the declaration of a Kunoran Vel is a cause for much celebration. It is one of few occasions when the Kunari are permitted to engage in revelry. There is imbibing of spirits, public chanting, meditations abandoned. It is madness.
That would be quite a sight.
It is interesting. It can take days for the Ben Hasrath to restore order. There may even be executions. I suppose I should tell you. I have decided to return to my people. Your quest is done, and thus so is my reason for accompanying you.
That will be a long trip home.
Yes, but it will be welcome to be amongst familiar things again. It must be said, you gave me the chance to redeem my honor, and now it is done. I owe you a debt.
You owe me nothing.
Some debts cannot be discarded. There will come a time when I will return, and then it shall be done. Perhaps we shall meet again. Should it be in battle, I will not seek you out. Panahedon Warden.
Don't see Tank anywhere. Oh well.
Are you ready, my lord? Crowds outside are getting restless.
Yes, I'm ready. Let's go.
Right. I'll take you there now. Follow me.
And here is the epilogue. In the months that followed his coronation, Alistair proved to be a popular king, if largely unwilling to involve himself in the matters of governing. He traveled often, making appearances in towns throughout Ferelden, to the great delight of the commoners. They referred to him as a king with the common touch, even if a few knew it was a simple aversion to life at court. News that the Urn of Sacred Ashes had been found in Ferelden did not spread outside the Chantry until Brother Genetivi made an announcement several months after the defeat of the Darkspawn. The manuscript detailing his research and his experience with Andraste's cult drew huge interest among the scholars throughout Thedas. Some years later, the Chantry announced that the resting place of Andraste's ashes had been found. A ripple of excitement spread among the pious people of Thedas, with many undertaking pilgrimages to see the ashes or partake of their healing powers. Following the months of effort, the Tower of the Circle of Magi was finally cleansed of the last spirits to slip through the veil. No further abominations were created, and First Enchanter Irving was pleased to declare the circle safe. All that could have been saved had been. With the slavers shut down in the alienage, a lot of city-born elves improved for a time. The new king named the local elf to his personal court, a scandal amongst humans, but a sign of hope to the elves. Shiani continued to be an outspoken member of the alienage community, and in time became the new elder. That outspokenness earned her frequent trouble, but served her people well. Arl Eamon remained in Denerim for some time, acting as the chancellor and chief advisor to the king, Alistair. Tegan ruled over Redcliffe in his stead, and was surprised to find himself well-loved by the villagers, who were still grateful for the nights he spent defending their lives. In time, Eamon abdicated in favor of his brother, an event the locals greeted with approval and enthusiasm. The Dalish elves prospered after the siege at Denerim, having earned much respect for their part in the battle. For once, human lands welcomed the wandering folk. The new keeper, Lenea, was respected both amongst the Dalish as well as in Ferelden court. She was a voice of reason, and other Dalish clans would turn to her to help resolve disputes with human folk. In time, many of the Dalish clans moved to the new land provided for them in the south near Ostagar. Wary of human neighbors, however, tensions soon rose again, and only Keeper Linnea's leadership kept the peace alive. In Orzammar, King Balin quickly proved himself a reformer. Trade with surface lands increased and caste restrictions were loosened. The castless were permitted to take arms against the Darkspawn in exchange for new freedoms. For the first time in the generation, the line in the deep roads was pushed back, and few taigs were reclaimed. Balin's reforms quickly found him enemies within the warrior and noble classes, however, and after several assassination attempts, the assembly was dissolved and the king ruled alone, and some said as a tyrant, others say as a visionary, determined to drag Orzammar into the modern world. The dwarven mage Dagna ultimately completed her studies at the rebuilt Circle Tower on the surface. Eventually, she published a comprehensive theory of how lyrium vapors relate to the supply of magic. It gained a great deal of attention. This inspired mages from other parts of Thedas to establish a new circle of magi in Orzammar itself, one that had readily access to dwarven lyrium and lies outside the Chantry's power completely. The willingness of Orzammar to harbor apostates sparked outrage and began whispers that the Divine was contemplating a new exalted march. Although the Anvil of the Void was destroyed, rumors of its location crept into Orzammar. Years later, thanks to the defeat of the Darkspawn on the surface, a few determined smiths managed to locate the Anvil's remains. They examined the ruins of the Anvil, and upon returning to Orzammar with their findings, convinced the Shepherate to attempt to recreate Carradine's research. A new golem was created, bound with a spirit taken from the Fade. The golem immediately went insane, killing several shapers before it was destroyed. The research was branded excessively dangerous and sealed away. Whispers of its existence circulated through Orzammar. however, and demanded among the Smith cast to reopen Carradine's research, refused to abate. As good as her word, Morgan disappeared once the archdemon was slain. Someone of Morgan's description was seen traveling alone months later, heading west through the Frostback Mountains, and she may even have been with a child. There was no word of her after that. With Flemeth dead, or at least gone, the chances of tracking her down were slim indeed. One cannot help but wonder, however, what became of the child? What were Morgan's plans? These questions must remain a mystery, for now. The companions who have traveled with Aiden eventually scattered to the four winds, drawn either by personal duty or the call to further adventure. The Grey Wardens welcomed their hero back into the fold, even if the suspicions of those who wondered how Aiden managed to survive were sometimes given quiet voice. As the blighted lands began to heal and the Grey Wardens slowly rebuilt their order in Amaranthian, they discovered that the fight against the Darkspawn was not yet complete. Although the Horde was routed and had dissolved upon the Archdemon's death, many of the more powerful Darkspawn survived to organize roving war bands that preyed upon the land and upon each other. These war bands spread havoc, and some even journeyed west into Orlais or across the Shining Sea by the Deep Roads. They proved incredibly difficult to wipe out. But these tales yet to be told. This tale ended when Aiden sank his blade into the Archdemon's head and destroyed it forever. It was not the last that Ferelden would hear of him. However, well, guys, this has been Dragon Age Origins. This was a fun game. Although I find the gameplay of Dragon Age 2 more fun, this one was pretty great. I loved the characters. I loved the story. Just the overall world of Dragon Age. It's beautiful. It's really beautiful. I cannot wait to see what my actions will do in Dragon Age 2. Unfortunately, I haven't seen what they will do yet. Because this is literally my second playthrough, and I haven't seen what the actions of my first playthrough would have done. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I did. This is 323 Starlight, signing off.